What's up, guys? RVBC6 here, and welcome to a, I guess, a brand new playthrough for me. You know, this is technically my third one now doing. I got Doom Eternal, and I got Borderlands 3 with the One Life playthrough. So yeah, this will be a playthrough of the story, Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War story. So yeah, I guess we'll just go right into it.
We must realize that no arsenal or no weapon in the arsenals of the world is so formidable as the will and moral courage of free men and women. It is a weapon our adversaries in today's world do not have. Let that be understood by those who practice terrorism and prey upon their neighbors.
Some U.S. intelligence analysts believe America is already in a state of war with the Soviet Union.
Are Soviet spies living among us?
52 American citizens have been taken hostage at the American Embassy in Tehran.
An unnamed White House official claims that a Cold War disaster could be just around the corner.
I know some of you who do watch me, you've seen this intro to the story, right? So, skip. Something happened.
You sure we can trust the police, Adler?
This guy's done more for less. You'll look the other way.
Yeah, he'll look the other way, all right.
Adler?
Glad you could join us, Hans. You remember Mason.
We cleared a move on a target.
Kasim is in his apartment, but he's well protected. I can keep my men out of the area for 15 minutes. I hope you brought an arm.
Sorry, guys. I'm just going on the stage real quick.
We brought enough. Pleasure doing business with you, Hans.
Hans.
Come on. Woods is itching for a dust up. We don't want to let him down.
Of course not. Can't let good old Woods down.
We're on the clock, Woods. It's not.
Oh, guys, just fixing my mic again. Good.
Hey, Mace. Party favors are in the trunk.
AK-74, you, with the Kodiak Recon, Milano 821 with the Talon Reflex and Foregrip, with the MP5, I'm gonna go with the Milano.
Dipshit probably thinks he's safe.
That piece of trash is a lot of things. Safe ain't one of them.
Hang on, it's not... Where?
Do we really need to take this son of a bitch alive, Adler?
Kasim has info we need. Everyone else can take a powder. Apartment's just up ahead.
Damn, I fucking...
Hans only bought us 15 minutes. We need to hit Kasim hard and fast. Let's go. Let's help him ring in the new year. Light him up, Mason.
Go, go, go!
Let's go!
Give me some fucking cover!
Hombre, go high lana, dude!
Move! Move!
Down.
I just handle the money. I have no idea where Arashi is.
I don't think you understand the situation.
You Americans have rules. You have rules.
You took hostages. The rules changed.
Wait. He's in Turkey. He's meeting someone in Trabzon airfield. Tomorrow night! I swear I don't know! They only communicate with coded messages!
There you go.
Thank you.
You gonna finish this, Mason?
Bye-bye.
No losing.
I couldn't resist. I'm sorry, guys. It's a little brutal, but I couldn't resist.
I'm not scraping him off the pavement.
Hudson, Arash is in trap zone, Turkey.
I can't look over that fucking building. I should just let him go. I should just let him do it.
Kasim is out of the picture.
How long before we get Arash?
The team arrived in Turkey a few hours ago. They should be in position shortly.
Airfield's just up ahead. Let's go find this shithead.
Priority is to ID Arash before things go hot. Check it out.
Yep, already on it.
That's not him.
I got the double kill there.
Whip, stop that plane!
Whip, pull the plane tanks off!
Oh, long range headshot. I don't know what just happened there. That was not my fault. I just didn't die.
His plan is already underway. You won't be.
be able to stop him this time.
Stop who?
Perseus.
Bullshit. Perseus is dead.
Dead? All this time that you didn't even know. Perseus will watch the west.
Hudson will want to hear about this. Let's sweep the tarmac for survivors and get to Langley.
Who the fuck is Perseus?
Perseus is the big bad wolf. Big bad wolf.
1943.
Wolf. Suckers.
Detailed information from the Manhattan Project was stolen from Los Alamos by the Russian spy known as Perseus. 1968, the Vietnam War. Viet Cong soldiers, orchestrated by Perseus, attempted to steal an American-made nuclear bomb from a U.S. firebase. 5 days ago, while on a mission, we acquired intel that Perseus is in play again and planning an attack on the West. Perseus, the CIA's analysts consider him to be the single largest threat to the free world.
Jason Hudson.
Mr. Hudson, we're all aware of Perseus. We're also aware he's more myth than fact. I mean, personally, I think he's nothing more than the Russian boogeyman.
General Haig, allow me to introduce the man best suited to respond to that. CIA clandestine special officer, Russell Adler. He's one of the few people who even come close to capturing Perseus.
Mr. Adler, why should we take this Perseus threat seriously?
You don't have to, sir.
Yeah, then a lot of innocent people are gonna die.
Why do you say that?
Sir.
Every time Perseus has come into play, it shifted the balance of the Cold War. After 13 years of silence, if he's active, something big is gonna happen. Something that will affect the free world.
Sir.
Mr. President.
Sir.
Mr. President.
Mr. President, this is Jason Hudson and Russell Adler.
I know their names. Who do you think approved their last mission?
President Reagan. Everybody.
Is the threat real?
Yes, sir, we believe it is.
Can you stop Perseus?
We can, sir. I've already submitted the requisition for my team.
Sir, their requests are highly irregular. Most likely illegal if the press gets a hold.
What the hell are you talking about? You know who we are?
Every mission we go on is illegal.
Sergeant Woods, plausible deniability is the backbone of our work.
Al, we're talking about preventing an attack on the free men and women of the world. Give Mr. Adler whatever he wants. Gentlemen, you've been given an important task. Protecting our very way of life from a great evil. There is no higher duty. There is no higher honor. And while few people will know of your struggles, rest assured, the entire free world will benefit. I know you won't fail us.
I was checking something. 5 weeks later.
This is Hudson.
How long until we have a lead on Perseus?
They're about to get started. Adler's in West Berlin. He should be at the safe house soon.
Do you trust him?
I'm not the one you should be asking, Black.
What about his team?
It's a strong group. He chased down Sims, Azalea, even pulled some strings to get Helen Park from MI6. We'll get them Mason and Woods soon.
I'm not so sure about Park.
She and Adler have that business from before. Of course he wants her there.
And the new one?
Bell? Well, don't get me started. That's the one we need to keep our eyes on.
Bell is me. I am Bell. I guess I'm struggling with how to put this. CIA. After a stunt with the Marine. After a stint with the Marines, Bell joined the CIA, serving briefly under Jason Hudson. Afterwards, Bell was assigned to Russell Adler's MacSog unit in Vietnam. Prior to joining Russell Adler's squad in 1967, Bell served with MI6. Reaching the rank of senior squad leader, operations involvement classified, ex-KGB. While operating as a KGB agent, Bell became an asset for the CIA, eventually defecting to the United States in 1965. Bell later became a full member of Russell Adler's MacSog team. I'm gonna leave it unclassified. That's need to know. Confirm.
Bell, welcome to West Berlin.
Thank you. And there's beautiful.
We've got a job to do. Mark.
Adler. Bell.
Get started. There's been a surge in Russian chatter in the last 48 hours. The CIA and the DOD are tapping their inside sources for anything substantial. So far, there are no leads on Perseus.
MI6 has come up empty-handed as well.
And we'll have to start somewhere. So we're going back here. Vietnam, 1968. One of our closest encounters with Perseus.
Shit. Some part of me always knew that mission wasn't done with us.
Pull up everything we've got on the attack in Da Nang and run it past Park. She'll cross-reference it with MI6.
We're looking for code names, encrypted transmission, Russian activity with NVA, anything that could be a lead.
Got it.
Bell, this is where you come in. Someone high up wanted you with us in Nam. I didn't think I needed you then, but I did. Now I need you again. Head to the evidence board. Retrace our steps through Da Nang. Anything that could give us a lead on Perseus.
That's it. Seems.
Bell, you're looking a little pale. You up for this? Good. You've just moved up on my favorite team member list. Right past Lazar.
Congratulations.
You just met her yesterday, right? I don't know. Why don't you ask her? Maybe you two have a special rapport. Keep it professional, Bell.
It's not my fault she's beautiful.
We're placing key intel up there. One for each mission. Forming connections. I want a red line right to Perseus. It'd be good for Park to hear it from us firsthand. Maybe we have overlooked something. The safe house? I've done time here before, years back. This go-round? Just a few days now. As for Czar, he can't get enough of safe houses. We've done some jobs together. Good guy, you'll like him. He keeps things light. Don't be a stranger.
I'm going to need to process some of these old negatives.
You can hit that whenever you're ready. The dark room's mostly functional. Just waiting on a couple more deliveries to finish it up.
Did I not talk to Sims? Hey.
A lot of this stuff's been sitting around for years.
I guess not.
How are things, Belle? In this case, quite. I understand you may have first-hand knowledge that could help us. It must be difficult, Belle. I can't claim to have experienced what you have. Perhaps going over it again could be therapeutic.
You look familiar. Have you worked together before?
You and I. It's entirely possible. I have a long collaborative history with other intelligence services. Our paths have likely crossed at some point.
Anything I can help you with?
Well, I'm keen to hear about your time in Indochina. So close to Perseus.
What do you know of Perseus?
Not nearly as much as I'd like. I have experience with others like Perseus. They're all chess players. I enjoy predicting the next move.
I'll leave you to it.
We'll talk again soon.
Czar.
Belle.
How long have you been with the CIA?
Working with the CIA over a decade. On their actual payroll? Going on about 5 years. I was born in D.C. Parents moved to Israel when I was a kid. Dual citizenship has its advantages.
You guys can tell that Lazar is a Burger Town fan. Israel.
Yeah. I landed in the Israeli Defense Forces out of
big
university.
Big fan of Burger Town.
Did a tour there. After that, the Mossad. That's when I first started working with the CIA. And occasionally, our boss man Adler over there.
Do you know of Perseus before this mission?
You probably know more than me. I guess it's something the top brass wanted to keep to themselves.
Sorry about the extra noise. I hear you enjoy safe houses.
This one is luxury. Fresh air, lots of room. Try being squeezed into a 500 square foot shithole with five other people. A long drive into Berlin is worth it. Believe me.
Later.
Enough talk.
Sims, heavy pack. Hell yeah. One sec.
I don't know why I can't talk to Sims, but.
Pretend like it's... what's his name? That guy back in Vienna. You know.
Alright guys, I'm gonna stop it here. And I will do this again. I'll probably do this again Monday night after Doom Eternal part. Next part of Doom Eternal. Alright. Oh wait, hang on, what's this? It's changing the channel. Alright, tell you guys in a couple days. Peace.